Molly's still on the couch with us. We've done the Swans, but the Shadow Secretary of State for Wales, Christina Rees, is back fit again. You had trouble. First of all, tell us what the injury was.
Well, I broke my metatarsals in my foot, and it was very early in the morning. I was listening to a certain radio show.
Yeah, was it?
No, it's all right. I'm not taking the blame for this one.
And you very kindly played Tiny Dancer, which is my favourite Elton John song, Tiny Dancer. And I slipped off the first step in the house, fell all the way downstairs, and was lying there screaming, thinking I'd just twisted it, but I broke it.
Mal Pope's fault then?
Yeah.
I take them. Where there's blame, there's a claim, Kev.
Well, you know, you kind of laid down for a while, weren't you?
Oh, I was housebound for 2 months, which nearly drove me potty.
And you can't really say very much about it, can you? Because you just have to get on with it and try and do the job as best you can in the meantime.
Yeah.
I can also think of far more dramatic and exciting ways of kind of doing your metatarsal and dancing to a Mal Pope song.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a good record, though, Kev. Yeah, it is a very good record.
Back in the House of Commons, how are things there?
Very exciting, Kevin. We're all still Brexiting. And next week is going to be the report stage of the withdrawal bills coming back next Tuesday and Wednesday. And the government have promised to amend it to make it more friendlier to the backbenchers. And they've laid their amendments down and they don't look too friendly at the moment.
But Nigel Farage yesterday was going on national television. He's on all the papers today. It's the Mirror, the Mail or the Express, certainly the big papers, saying let's have another referendum in the belief that the vote would be very similar and that would end it once and for all. And it kind of was ended once and for all once we had a Democratic vote anyway. But he wants another one now. If that's not going to happen, is it?
That's not going to happen. I mean,
is he saying that because he knows it's not going to happen?
Yeah. And I think he's pinched Geraint Davis's idea. Because Geraint has been on about that for ages. But seriously, yes, there's been a shift slightly. The polls are saying that, you know, if the referendum would happen again, that it would be a different result. But people have shifted either way. You know, we've accepted the result. I mean, I'm a Remainer. I was a European candidate. I wanted to stay in Europe. But I've accepted the result of the referendum, and we need to get on with it to make sure the final deal is one that benefits Wales and the UK.
It would be quite hilarious if we had another vote and they voted to remain. What would we do then? Best of three? Would be, wouldn't it? You know, next one wins.
Yeah, but, Farage is just... That's against UKIP policy. So does he get chucked out now as being a member of UKIP?
Politics is, populist politics has changed, today. All the stuff from Trump as well. Mm. I'm sure people in private do use language, Christine. I'm not saying you do, politicians, but I'm sure they do use quite robust and, flowery language. But to actually do it out loud in front of the media and play to your base, that sounds like the 30s and the 40s, doesn't it, rather than the 21st century?
And Trump is a master at that, isn't he? Because I have friends who moved to America from the UK and were perhaps conservative when they were here, and they are now Trump supporters, and they will not accept that anything that is said about him is true. And I'm sure amongst all the stuff that's said, not everything is actually entirely accurate. But you have to accept sometimes when these same themes, these same accusations keep coming up time and time and again, that a man going saying fake news, that wouldn't be enough in other parts of the world. But to the Americans who support him, he can do no wrong.
Yeah, I never thought we'd have a president of the United States running America via Twitter. Mm-hmm. And that's what he's done. And he clears people out. If they don't agree with him, he just sacks them and they go. So there's no continuity there. But I've got a friend, Adam Schiff, who's the leading Democrat on the Intelligence Committee. So he's leading the inquiry into how were the Russians involved in the election. And he thinks that he is highly implicated. But the question we must ask is, will he be impeached? Because that's the only way to get rid of him. And I'm not so sure that they'll take that step.
When you say Adam Schiff, this guy, because he's all over the news, isn't
he? He's great, yeah.
And he, but he's been here.
Yeah, he's been to Neath.
Neath?
Yeah, been to Neath.
Was wrong with Swansea then? He didn't come back.
He's not ready for it yet, Kevin.
Dear me, dear me.
I went over on a parliamentary working party, and they pay you off with a congressman. And I got paired...
I get confused as well.
I got paired with Adam Schiff, who's the congressman for Hollywood.
Oh, so, Neath, Hollywood.
Yeah.
Do you see where they did it?
So on Friday afternoon, we just took this plane to Hollywood, and then on Monday we came back to the Congress, and that's what they do all the time. But out of the blue, I got an email. I'm coming over to the UK. Can I come and see you? Happy days. So he came to Neath, and we did all the things that you do with a congressman, like we took him down a coal mine. and showed him Dev Workshop in Banwyn.
Brilliant.
And Onflowing Choir sang for him.
Fantastic.
And he was actually crying with emotion because they don't do that over there.
Yeah. No. I'd heard that he'd been told that Bay Studios was in Neath, the Neath boundaries, and he's maybe thought it was like L.A.
The thing is, we are exotic, aren't we? We're somewhere in the world, we are the exotic ones.
Yes,
just to realise that. We have something special about us, and we should, as you always do, you shout loud and proud about it.
Yeah. You didn't bring me any cake. You've been handing out cake in Swansea Market today.
Well, I had heard that you were on a diet.
I am. 10 pounds gone since Christmas.
Wow.
So I didn't want to tempt you know.
Don't ask.
Where's it gone from?
It's an important issue, isn't it? And there's been some movement. The Welsh Assembly are now starting to step in. But for goodness sake, how long does this Lagoon paperwork have to be on somebody's desk? And all they have to say is yes. Or if it's not going to happen, just get it over with so we know and we can move on to something different.
Kevin, I don't understand why they just don't give it the green light. Because even Hendry, and it's the first anniversary of his report today, which is why we're in Swansea Market, me and Rob Stewart handing out birthday cake, just raising awareness. But Hendry said, get on with it. You know, it's a no regrets policy. Our shadow minister, Rebecca Long Bailey, came down and we took her out in a boat around the bay. She said, this is a wonderful scheme. So we've got Labour Party back in it at UK level. Alan Cairns, every time I ask him, he wears questions, and all the other Welsh MPs ask him as well. We don't get an answer.
He seems to be in favour, though, doesn't he?
I don't know. I can't tell. But if you look at the costings, it's going to come in under the price for Hinkley Point Power Station. And what we need is long-term sustainable energy planning, and this gives it to us. And not only will there be a tidal lagoon in Swansea, there'll be four around the Welsh coast. Yeah.
Being the first is great, isn't it, in anything? Because people always come to you and wonder what mistakes you've made and how they learn from it. You know, we become a world centre, not just a British centre, a Welsh centre. Yeah. So it just seems to be just pressed.
Well, there's no doubt the focus of the world would have been on Swansea Bay, and you know, we would have made news all over the world. And just as you know, it's a completely different thing. But the Swans have put Swansea on the map globally, and people talk about Swansea who maybe wouldn't have again. But now we're desperate to get this because it means so much to our local community.
It means so much. It's jobs, it's growth, it's infrastructure, it's sport.
Yeah.
You can have a triathlon there. It's tourism. There's a tourism centre going to be built on the wall that's going round.
Mal would have written a musical about it.
I have already.
You have?
I've been out 5 minutes. I had a little chat with Christina. I think I've got the opening songs.
What's encouraged me today was they interviewed Hendry this morning, and he still thinks that it's possible because the government hasn't said no.
Yeah.
And he used to be a Conservative MP. He used to be the energy minister for the Conservative government. So surely he's got contacts.
Yeah.
So I take that as positive.
And he's also got the experience and the knowledge from that political perspective, isn't he? So what do you expect? What's your gut feeling?
I don't know. I mean, somebody once said to me, you're depressingly optimistic. And I said, thank you for the compliment. But that's me. I'm optimistic about everything. So I'm holding on to that.
Yeah.
And it makes no sense to say no.
Yeah, and it's, you know, if without hope, you know, without vision, you know, the people die, don't they? Yeah. So it's like we need politicians, we need, you know, people who will keep going, because it's persistence, isn't it? As Nelson Mandela said, everything's impossible until it's done. Mm. You know, and that's a case with this. We just must not let it go, must not let it lie. Because once you go quiet, it's easy to shift it, you know, kick it into the long grass. So keep.
The three of us, we've come from, you know, working class background.
Yeah.
I went to a comp, you know, and if you'd asked me, if you said to me then you were going to become Shadow Secretary of State for Wales, I'd say, oh, get over it. Get over yourself. Yeah. That's not going to happen. But it gives you aspiration because you keep fighting.
Absolutely.
Thanks for joining us. Come back and see us again. Mal, come back and talk football next week. Yeah, and we'll be back tonight at 6:30 here on Big TV.